Just a small clarification. Last time when we were discussing this frequency sampling method, over here I discussed about 2 pi by 11. Instead of this, I wrote omega. So it is basically 2 pi by 11 alpha k. Okay. Rest of the numericals, it is okay. But by mistake, I have written 2 pi by 11 to omega. So please correct your notebooks. So, do you have any problem with anything? Any questions you would like to ask?
Sir, 11 is here. L, hello.
See, n already
Papa,
given.
11 that.
We will be discussing about
Yes, sir.
n, which is the order of the filter, and L will be discussing as n plus 1.
One, yeah.
So for finding HN, are there two different methods?
Yeah, there are two very different methods. We have already discussed in one of the previous thing that there are two
Yes, sir.
methods. One we can find out from h of minus n to h of n, and other one we can find out, and say sorry, minus n to n, minus n by 2 by n by 2, sorry. And in the other one we can go for H0 to H of n.
So based on these two, the filter realization will be depend. One is linear phase, another one is direct form, right?
No, you're absolutely
No.
incorrect. Your minus n by 2, it cannot be realized because say H of minus n, it cannot be realized. Why? Anyone can answer him? Why it cannot be realized?
So the system will become
It is
non-causal.
not called.
Yeah, exactly. So you will be having H of minus n multiplied by H of minus z to the H of minus n multiplied by z to the power minus of minus n, which will become H of minus n multiplied by H to the power n. And this operator, which is an advanced operator, it is not feasible to implement. So you are talking about take future values and then compute the output.
Sir, only applicable for causal system, this Zipf filter.
Any filter, whether it is FIR or IR filters, they can be realized only and only when they are causal systems. Yeah. Anything else?
Sir,
So
in
in the previous
book,
slide,
yeah. Yeah.
so previous to this normalization of frequency,
Which one?
or I think, so
This
normalization of
one?
frequency, we were designing LPF only.
Yeah, this one?
Sir, the last problem where you have said that omega we have to take 2 pi by 11, so that problem itself. Yes sir, this one. So here in step one we have taken normalization of the frequency, but in this question we haven't used it anywhere, no?
No, we have used it. If you see pi by 2, so if you look over here, what you are doing, you have to calculate these values, na? These are k delta values, and what are the limits you will be taking, because others will be zero. In this case, we talked about that these values would be zero, right?
Yes sir.
Yeah.
Yes sir, yes sir.
And these values we would be taking as 1 up to 10.
Yes sir.
Because whatever you do, you have to first look into this frequency response of the filters, right? So that's why we have dedicated one full class on what would be the different frequency responses of the filters. Because if you do not understand these frequency response, how the band pass filter will be having its frequency response, or the band stop filter will be having the frequency response, taking these limits would become difficult for you. It's slightly different than analog filter. In analog filter, we just put the frequency responses in the positive frequency domain. However, in this one, in digital systems, you have to also consider the negative filters. Not negative filters, sorry, negative frequencies.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, in case of HPF, this pi by 2 will become the minimum cutoff frequency.
That also we have discussed, and I have given you the class assignment. Anyone who can tell me what happened, what will happen?
Yes, sir.
Minus pi by 2.
So we will be having high pass filters. That means it you will be having this thing, right?
Mirroring.
So pi by 2 to this 3 pi by 2, sorry, over here, right? This region. And then what will happen? This red mark regions, this will be having a value of zeros. And we have talked that this region and this region previously where we have taken ones, they will become zero, and k equals to 3 to 8, it would become 1. Right?
Yes.
And accordingly, yes, then we will proceed. I think we have already discussed it in last class.
Yes, I was asking that, like in low pass frequency, pi by 2 is becoming the highest cutoff frequency. So in high pass, that is the use of that pi by 2, just to confirm.
So anything else?
Sir, here in this particular problem, HN formula is given by this HN equal to 1 by N plus 1, that one. Mm-hmm. But in the book, I saw another one that is given HN equal to 1 by 11, that is the length, into summation of k equal to 0 to N, into HK to E to the J 2 pi by KN, the different that one. So both are valid.
I didn't get 1 by 11, then?
Summation of k equal to 0 to 10, that is the n value, into hk into e to the j 2 pi by k n by 11.
This is 1 by 11. Further, what you said, instead of this one, what you are telling?
The another formula was given there as 1 by 11 into summation of k equal to 0 to 10.
0 to 10. Both are valid, because if you see 0 to 10, whenever you will be putting this one, so it would become 1, na? This is becoming 1, na? So k, yes, if you put 0, so it would become 1. However, this 2, what we are doing, we are taking the case for both before and after this one. So 2 is being multiplied because we know these filters, these components, the higher components, they would become they would be repeating itself, right? The frequency components.
Yes, sir.
Whereas H0 component is the only component where we do not have the repetition, because we take 0 to, though we said 2 pi, we basically take less than 2 pi, right?
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, they will be aliasing. So you have to be careful with this one. These components, that's why you've seen k equals to 1 to L minus 1 by 2 we have taken. So L minus 2 means 11 minus 1, 10 divided by 2, 5. Right. So we are taking half the values, and rest half we are not taking. Because if we take 0 and 11, and that's why I told you, no, last time, that that's why we are not considering this 11, because 0 and 11, they will be repeating themselves. So we don't want any repetition. Right?
Yes, sir.
So anything else? Any other doubts?
So can you explain that a power spectrum density concept? It is in our lab, our next lab, so I'm not getting.
Power spectral density, it's in lab.
Yes, sir. Lab 7.
Sir, I have given one program to calculate the power spectral density of the
system. ये क्या है ना, what is the meaning of that one that she is asking? So it is nothing but your power is x square, na? So it is basically your modulus of h of omega square with respect to omega. Okay, what do you mean by power? Power is say over a period of time, period 1 by t integral of whatever the integral minus t by 2 to t by 2, then we are having modulus of it is summation summation n equals to minus t by 2 to t by 2 x of n modulus whole square, right? So, and this should be, sorry, capital N, right? So it is something like this. So here what you do, when you go for PhD, as far as I remember, because I haven't seen the stuff, I may be a bit wrong, but the funda is you calculate the power with respect to the frequency in the frequency domain, and then you calculate this thing. So power spectral density with respect to the frequency. So that would give you the variation at whatever the frequency you are having. Suppose you are taking a sinusoidal of 10 Hertz. So you will find that at 10 Hertz, sorry. So at 10 Hertz frequency, your modulus of H omega whole square, it would be highest. So this is the power spectral density, means around the 10 Hertz signal, if you are using this 10 Hertz signal, and if you are finding out the frequency over there, so what is happening? It is a pure tone. So in the pure tone at 10 Hertz, you will be getting a sharp peak. So at 10 Hertz, the power is maximum of this signal. This is the funda. And it is quite understood, because if it is a pure tone signal, okay, if it is a pure tone signal, it will be having only 10 Hertz components. Okay. And due to the non-idealistic nature of the hardware component, you will get this kind of curve. Otherwise, if everything was real, you would have got a peak something like this, just a straight line. Okay. But due to the non-idealistic nature, you will get some spread in the peak. So, yeah.
Sir,
power spectral densities. Sir, power spectral density is also the Fourier transform of autocorrelation function.
Fourier transform. Yeah. So what you do basically, what you are telling it's correct. So how do you measure the Fourier transform basically? What is there in the Fourier transform?
The frequency components.
Omega divided by h of omega. Modulus of h of omega. Okay. So
yes,
when you
yes.
talk of the power spectrum, spectral density, PSD, so we call it power. Why power? If you see, power is signal to the power 2. Right? So that's why I
yes,
told there are two terms. I forgot another term. One is PSD, another is normal Fourier transform or something like that, which we'll be discussing later on, of course. So one is just modulus of h of omega and the other is square of this one. Okay. As far as I remember, power spectral density is the square value. So what you do when you talk about how the Fourier transform is being measured. So suppose you are having a sinusoidal signal, okay, which is continuing. So you start with a DC signal, then do the correlation. Okay. Then, you take a frequency component, a PO tone frequency, this thing, sinusoidal wave of very high frequency. Okay. Then you do the correlation. So they will not match. So what you do? Then at that time you will be having very low or minimal correlation. Then what you do? You stretch this signal, basis signal. When you stretch this basis signal, your frequency component, the wavelength increases, frequency component decreases, so you come here. Okay, again there is no match, again there is no match. Ultimately, when you try to come near to 10 hertz, the correlation will start increasing and it will reach a maximum, then again it will start decreasing and it will be minimum. So the maximum will be at 10 hertz for a 10 hertz EM. So you are doing the auto not basically autocorrelation, or you can say autocorrelation because you are taking sinusoidal signal, but here the sinusoidal signal, which is the basis signal, we call it the basis signal. So we take this basis signal and then we stretch it and again autocorrelate it, not cross correlate it, and again then stretch it, again auto cross correlate it. So in that way, from higher frequency, we scan the signal or we do the auto cross correlation towards the lower frequency, right? So it is not exactly autocorrelation, but if you say, okay, if you have 10 hertz signal and if you want to find out whether 10 hertz signal is there, so you take the basis signal as 10 hertz signal and you go for the autocorrelation, and when you go for the autocorrelation, you will be getting a value of 1. Okay, and when you go for this square, 1 square, it is always 1. So maximum value you will be getting 1, but PSD there is a square term, because if you look into the power, you just remember this one, when we calculate the power, there is a modulus of xn square. So from there, what is this modulus of xn square? It is not the n term. We are basically squaring the amplitude term, right? So if you have seen the this in correlation of the Fourier transform and the different transforms, what we have seen in the Fourier transform, if you have a given signal xt, you apply Fourier transform and you get to capital X of omega. Okay. And when you apply this thing, inverse Fourier transform, you get to the time domain. So what is happening? In the first case, in xt, you are having time and you are having amplitude. Right? And in x omega, what you have? You have omega and amplitude. In both the case, in these two cases, the y axis, that is amplitude. Okay? And you are just doing the amplitude modulation. So whenever you are trying to calculate the power in the time domain, if you try to calculate the power in the frequency domain also, then you have to square it, square the amplitude values. Okay, but over there it will be with respect to the frequency component. That's why we call power spectral. Spectral means frequency, density. So how the density is changing. Okay. Anything else? No? Anything from the theory as of now?
So what will be the syllabus of the test?
What are you telling?
Syllabus for the test, sir, 17.
Whatever have been taught, whatever will be taught to you up to tomorrow, that will be your syllabus.
Sir, okay, sir, but sir, from which lecture we are covering in download on YouTube, sir? From
past lectures, what are the
lectures? You calculate it since when we have started. We have started from September 21, right? So after that, we have completed 4 weeks. 3 weeks. 3 multiplied by 3, it's 9. And 2nd of October, it was a holiday. So if you negate that, so we get 8 lectures. So 8 lectures from the past and from 21, whatever has been covered, no, whatever will be covered up to tomorrow.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So I think we have already, we have just covered 14 lectures. So 8 lectures we have already covered. So 2 more weeks and we will not be we will be we would have covered all the previous lectures, old lectures, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and then from there, after that you'll be feeling better.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, then if you have nothing to ask for this theory class, then we will stop over here and then we can continue with the lab. So Deblu is here.